Here's a powerful quote for you. If you can't measure it, you can't improve it. It applies to business, it applies to engineering. Of course, it applies to emails as well. So if you're looking to improve the performance of your emails, your email marketing campaigns, the first step you need to take is to start tracking those emails. That means having some email logs. And if you're not tracking those emails, if you don't have email logs enabled on your site, you can't do any of that. So let's fix that in this video. Because in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up email logs on your WordPress website. Let's go. Before I show you the actual process, there's one important piece of information you need to understand, especially if you just built a website or you're planning to build a website very soon. Most WordPress websites out of the box, that means the default configuration, won't be able to send out emails at all. The technical reason is that most hosts are not configured in a way to send out emails. So you need to take some steps just to send out emails, and logging is a different process altogether. Well, there's some good news and there's some better news. The good news is that configuring an SMTP service, which is what you need to do, is very easy using just a free plugin. And the better news is that once you configure an SMTP service with a logging service, you can start logging emails at the same time by sending emails. So that's what exactly what I'm gonna show you, how to set up an SMTP service, which you need to do using a free plugin, and also how to start logging your emails as well using the same plugin. Now let's start the process. So I'm inside the admin area of my WordPress website, and as I promised, we'll be using a plugin to configure an SMTP service, and the plugin will also log our emails for us. So I'm already in the plugin section, the add new plugin section. You can see it right here. Let's search for the plugin that I'm going to recommend to you, which is called WP Mail SMTP. So I'm going to type that in, WP Mail SMTP, and wait for a few seconds for the search to happen. And this is the plugin I'm referring to, WP Mail SMTP by WP Forms. You can look at the ratings and the overall installation of the plugin. Over 3 million websites with 3,500 plus 5-star ratings. So it's a fantastic plugin. It's free. There's some limitations in the free version, which I'm going to talk about. But this is the first step you need to take if you just want to start sending the emails first from your website. So let's click the Install Now button. It'll take a few seconds for the plugin to install. And the plugin is installed. Let's also activate the plugin. So the plugin is now installed and activated on the site, WP Mail SMTP, you can see it right here. I'll go to the plugin settings and I'll start describing what steps you need to take to start sending out emails and also the conditions you need to fulfill to start logging your emails as well. All right, let me open WP Mail SMTP. I'll go to settings here. Now, just to give you an idea or just to give you an understanding of what the plugin does, it configures or it helps you configure an SMTP mail service on your website. So instead of trying to send out emails from your own server, you connect with an external service which is designed to send out emails, and you connect with that service and that service sends out emails for you. This is what the free version does. If you want the logging and the reporting features, that's available in the premium version. I'll leave a link down in the description of this video where you can check it out. I have the license key already. I'm going to activate it later in this video. Right now, let me demonstrate what steps you need to do just to start sending out the emails on your site. So I'm in this general settings or the settings of the plugin. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to come to the mailer section. And this is where we start configuring what service we want to use to send out emails from our site. The default one is PHP, which is your own server, own hosting provider, which, as I said, does not work most of the time. So you'll need to choose any of these SMTP services or mailer services that are available to you, and you will need to configure your plugin with them first. So send SMTP or SMTP.com or SendinBlue, these are the recommended ones. Then you also have Amazon AWS, you have Gmail accounts. So let's say if you're just starting a personal website, you want to just send a handful of emails, you can configure your personal Gmail account as well. You have Mailgun, you have 365 or Outlook.com, you have Postmark, SendGrid, and a bunch of others as well. Now, just to give you understanding what SMTP service you should be using, if deliverability is very important to you, you should use SendLayer. It's highly recommended. If you send mass emails or you have a lot of volume of emails, maybe choosing Amazon SES is a better solution for you. And if you're just sending out a handful of emails, just testing out your site, just seeing, or your website is not currently live, so in the meantime, you would just want to test out the emails, you can use the Gmail integration. So once any of the integrations that you utilize, you'll need to perform some configuration steps. And of course, it's not in the scope of this video to explain how it works, but the process is very simple. You can just Google the terms, how to set up SMTP.com on my website, and it's going to give you some basic steps. So for example, if I set up use Google or Gmail, it's going to give me some of these information or some of these, I'd say, configuration options to fill up, and I can just Google the terms. I can find out what my account is. I can go into steps and configure these settings here. This is the first absolute step you need to take even before you can log this, because if there's no emails going out, what are you logging, right? So once you've configured these kind of options, or I say any of the SMTP services available to you, your website will start sending out emails. Now, those emails can come from WordPress own security features, let's say automatic updates. It can come from other security plugins. It can come from any other plugins you've installed. It can come from like password reset emails or any other kind of emails. All those emails, once you've configured, will be logged by WPMail SMTP if you have the pro version installed. So now that I explained, I'm also going to activate the pro version first. I'm going to go into the settings of the email logging feature because you need to enable it. Now I'm going to also talk about a couple of options that you can configure there. So give me 1 second. I'll just go here and I'm going to purchase, or I say paste my license key here. So just give me 1 second. I'll pause the video for a second. And I'm going to paste the license key here. I'm going to connect. And I'm going to connect and install WPS MTP Pro. And what will happen, the free version of the plugin will be disabled and the pro version of the plugin will automatically be installed on my site. So once that is done, you'll notice that the pro version of the plugin is now installed. And I have now access to the logging features that is very, very important, or the point of the video is, right? So if I go to the email log feature, this is where I start configuring the settings for email logging. The default options, I believe, are like this. So you just see the first option, which is enable log with a checkbox. So of course, if you want to start logging your emails where you can track the performance, you need to enable this option. But once you enable this option, there are a couple of other options will also be present to you. Now, keep in mind, this is important to understand. Log email content and save attachments. So what does log email content does? So what it does is also log the entire content of the email, what is being sent out, the actual text in the email. Now, this can be very, very important because you can compare the what kind of copy is working for you if you're sending out marketing emails. But a lot of times it can also be a security risk because many times people will reset their passwords and it will contain temporary passwords that they have. A lot of payment information, security information, or a lot of personal information can also be present in emails. And if you enable this checkbox here, then all that information will be stored on your website, which might be, might not be compliant with local laws or data privacy rules. You have to keep that in mind as well. And it can also be a security risk because if you have temporary passwords stored in plain text, this is without encryption, that can also be a security risk on the site. So unless you have a compelling reason, you have your understanding of, and you have an understanding of data protection, data privacy laws, do not enable this feature. You also have the save attachment. So let's say you're sending out images or some PDF files, you want to save those attachments as well. You have the option to, but again, keep in mind, both these options have to be really, really thought of and then enabled on the site if you really need to. Then you also have some basic options like tracking email opens and also tracking link clicks in emails, which I recommend that you do. And once you've done, you can also configure the log retention period. So let's say you send out emails, a lot of emails, you might want to just limit this to maybe 6 months, 1 month, or 1 year, but let's keep it to forever for this particular use case. So once you've configured all these options, you will say save your settings, and the settings will be saved. And now any future emails going out from your site will be logged on your site. Now, of course, this is a test website. This has no content on it. And I cannot magically send 1,000 emails just to test the logging feature. So what I'm going to do is open a live website where I have this plugin already configured. I'm going to show you how the logs appear and what kind of features you have in the logging feature. All right, just give me 1 second and we'll be back. All right, I'm back and I'm logged into a live website which has been using WPMail SMTP for some time now. And the logs is what I've opened on the screen. You can see I'm in the email log section. And what this menu entries is actually showing me is a lot of the logs, or I'll say all the logs of all the emails being sent out from my site. Of course, I've blurred out some confidential information like emails, but you can still see that these are emails that have been sent out from the site. And the green dot which you see here is that it's just showing a success message that all these emails were attempted to be sent out, and because the configuration of the SMTP service is perfect, that means the emails were actually sent out. But let's say your configuration fails, or your payment fails, or you're using a paid service which rejects your emails, you might see a red icon here, a red logo here, a red circle here, noting that email was attempted to send out but it failed. So that's an easy way to understand that all these emails are working. And of course, I have blurred out the emails, but you can, if you're using on your website, you can actually configure the actual email address that you want to use from your website. So let's say you're using a branded email from xyz@yourwebsite.com. You can actually configure it inside the plugin as well. And of course, we are also seeing the source of the actual email. That means what plugin or what service or what was the reason for that email to be sent out. So in this case, you see WP forms. So once someone fills a entry or fills out a form on my website, on this website, email is generated automatically to this particular email address. So that's the first source. Then you also have WordPress security. So WordPress is a security plugin. It sends out periodical emails about plugins that need updating or other security issues that it finds. So that's the one of the sources of the emails. Then the WP SMTP Mail Pro or WP Mail SMTP Pro is also sending me emails about some weekly summaries about what emails being sent out. So that's also a nice, neat feature that I can utilize. And of course, if you use any of other services to connect using marketing emails or we're sending out other password reset emails, those will be shown up here as well. So let's open up one of these logs to show you how the logs appear, what details are actually captured in the logs. So let me open up this WordPress security email. I'll just click the view log button and I'll open it up. So this is the basic log. Again, of course, blurred out the emails for privacy reasons, but you can see all the email details. When was the email sent out? What timing? Which email was used? So from email and what email it was sent to, which email it was sent to, and what was the subject of the email. And on the right, you have the status of the email was sent and what was the mailer on this website. Amazon SES is the mailer that's being used. So it's listing out the mailer as well. How many attachment, log ID, was the email open? Was the links or any links clicked? And what was the source of the email? You can delete the log as well if you like. And you have some actions as well. So you can print it out, you can export it or in different formats. And if you enable the complete email saving feature, which I mentioned here, this particular feature, then you'll also see a feature of resending these emails. Again, that's completely up to you if you want to save the complete attachments or complete email body. But if you do, you'll have an option of resending the email as well. And if I open up the technical details and scroll to the bottom, you'll see the entire email headers being captured as well. So this entire details about what emails sent out or just technical information, the header of the email. So this is the entire log of what this particular email was. But this is not the most powerful thing inside the plugin, because logging is important. This is interesting to see. But what about trends? What about aggregate data, right? That's more important to a business owner. That if, let's say, you are a WooCommerce website owner, how many emails were sent out for order related emails? What they opened, what they clicked? That is the kind of data you need. So that for that data, you'll need to go to the email reports option. Again, click this link here, which will open email reports. And this will show you a nice graph of number of emails that have been sent out and how many failed, how many were opened, how many links were clicked, how many emails were sent out, a nice, easy to follow graph. And of course, you can also see daily reports here. So for the last 7 days, you can filter those reports out and you can instantly see what kind of emails are being sent out. So for example, let's say you're sending marketing type emails, you can instantly see status here of, okay, this is the subject line that you sent to how many people, how many were sent, were there any failures, what's the open count, and you can also see the graph for those specific things as well. So this is the kind of important data that will help you make business decisions based on this important data. And that's the point, right? If just logging emails just to see that the emails were being sent out, that's not really important. That's not something you can base important decisions on. WP Mail SMTP gives you this kind of data, which helps you make those decisions and instantly see in a bird's eye view of what's happening with emails on your WordPress website. And that's the most powerful feature. And I think this is the most important feature inside the plugin that I would recommend that you check out and you utilize to understand the performance of emails and use this data to improve the marketing performance of your emails on your WordPress website. I hope I was able to explain all of the details in an easy to understand manner. If I did, I'll hit the like button and I'll understand that, okay, I was able to explain these concepts easily. If you have any questions about this plugin or the how to configure this plugin, leave that in the comments. I'll answer it as soon as possible. And of course, this is the end of the video, but if you want a detailed video about how to configure WP Mail SMTP, I'll leave a couple of videos on the screen, which you can click and check out details about this plugin. And of course, subscribe to this channel for easy to follow along WordPress tutorials, and I'll catch you in the next video.